Thank you, Will, for having debated at such great length our website. I hope lots of people will look it up and get some more inspiration and ideas from it. There were a few odd things we heard in the repost to what I consider Gareth's very excellent plea for natural beekeeping, and that is Gareth has created a dichotomy, we were told, but then a few sentences later we were told there is no dichotomy and we basically have a lot in common. Well, if that is so, if we have a lot in common, that's brilliant. We want to have a lot in common. We want to have a lot in common not only with all of you, but for the whole of the rest of the world. We want everyone to love bees and to take great care and to revere them. But to keep myself in order, I'll just have a quick look at my notes. I hope I've picked up on a few of the things that have been said. I won't comment on the image of natural beekeepers sort of just putting up a few boxes and hoping that swarms will go into them. That's kind of primitive and doesn't really need responding to. I think there's a lot of material about, one book was mentioned by Ross Conrad, the American book. There is very good British literature on natural beekeeping. There's David Heath's book, The Bee-Friendly Beekeeper, has been fantastically reviewed about 2 years ago. So we have our own very British product in that. Now the question, do we have things in common? I should hope so. I hope we all care deeply for the future welfare of the bee in the overall context of nature. Perhaps we can agree on a realization that has become a certainty to me over the years of dealing with bees and looking at agriculture and looking at the whole picture, that beekeeping in the last 100 years, it has become technically and scientifically extremely sophisticated. But when you look at the moral considerations, and there are moral considerations, I put it to you, it is a moral issue. We're dealing with something that's alive, that is vital for the survival of the whole of nature and our food. It is definitely a moral issue, but morally, this technically and scientifically highly advanced beekeeping, morally, it has become bankrupt, it has become crude. The bees are expected to forage predominantly on toxic flowers. Are we supposed, as beekeepers, not to take any interest in that? Are we really okay joining a major beekeeping charity in the country and giving that our money, who take no stance on this issue? I think that's wrong. We are releasing our bees on a toxic landscape, on toxic flowers, and we're treating them with toxic chemicals, and we're treating them, most of all, with a false sense, I put it to you, a false sense of superiority that we know best. That we know best. We know whether the colony has too many drones. We take the right, what gives us the right to mutilate queen bees, to meddle with the inner sanctum of the brood nest, to kill off male bees, thus to assert our own, what I would call, lack of wisdom over a creature that is so wise, so able, so purposeful, in fact, so wonderful that in all ancient cultures it has been revered. Have we really progressed? Have we progressed when we look at the beekeeping scene today and the situation of the bees? We can see, I hope you will agree with me, a kind of impoverishment on all levels. Forage, numbers of bees, harvest of honey, general attitude to bees in the general population, status of knowledge about bees. All this has become impoverished. It all has happened, if we are of a certain vintage age, it has happened in our watch. How will we explain this to our children? How would we actually explain to our children why we go along in a beekeeping meeting and are learning, in many beekeeping meetings that I have attended, how to clip the queen, the wings of the queen bee? How do we explain this to children? We can only hope to solve the problem that we have today with bees and with agriculture as a whole if we first acknowledge the problem, if we really take honest stock and say, well, I personally may not have created the problem, but I'm one of the community of people who have let the problems arise. We need to look at ourselves. We need to think, what are the qualities that a child has A child approaches the world of nature with a sense of wonder. Children have reverence for things. We've lost that in our adult lives, and I suggest that we need to regain a sense of the wholeness of nature, of the fact that nature makes things whole if we let it. Gareth has said in his plea at the beginning of this evening, if we lose our trust in something, fear will follow. Fear breeds the desire to control. I put it to you that a lot of modern beekeeping is controlling, is springing from an attitude that we, the human beings, know better than the bees. Gareth also said, trust is free. Learn to trust nature and work within her rules. We know full well that in beekeeping, and also in the whole of the ways we practice agriculture, we are so very far removed from that. As beekeepers, we need to take an interest in how agriculture, how gardening is done in our country. This is one of the reasons why the Natural Beekeeping Trust has indeed formed alliances with other environmental groups in order to campaign against neonicotinoids. But the shameful thing is that we're the only beekeeping organization who are actually in that alliance. We have, as human beings, an over-controlling attitude of nature, and this attitude, if we stick to it, if we insist on it, it will head us for disaster. In farming, in gardening, in beekeeping, in fact, in all areas that touch on life, on the living, in all areas we are heading for disaster until we change our ways. Let us work hard to see the whole picture, to see the bees as part of their environment, to see the bees for what they really are, for these wonderful, in the past they used to refer to them as messengers from the god. They are the ones who keep the world in fruit and flower. How dare we treat them with anything but reverence? Can we really find it in ourselves to trust in the powers of nature, to trust in gentle husbandry, to trust in the wonderful gifts that nature has for us? And the supreme gift of nature, I would suggest, is the honeybee. Let's treat her with the reverence she deserves. Let's cherish the bee, and let's inspire others, and especially the children who will be the beekeepers of the future or the bee lovers of the future. Let's work hard to inspire all of them to join us in the great love we probably, all of us, however we keep bees, feel for the bees. Thank you.